Hi dear students, as you are watching the session, that means you are excited for the session 3. In first two sessions we learned maps, old and new terminologies, historians and resources, value of paper, new social and political group. So we'll start session 3 and the topic is region and empire. India, there were several kingdoms in several regions. Like in Rajasthan, they had their own kingdom. Bengal had their own kingdom. Different places had their different royal families. These all were called as regional kingdoms. These kingdoms always fought with each other. The one who won was to undertake the losing kingdom under his rule or kingdom. In such way, if any kingdom conquered any kingdom and brought them under his rule, then the kingdom was called empire. These empires had no boundaries. The emperor always wanted to increase the boundaries of his empire for expansion. The period of 1000 years that we are learning had many such regional kingdoms and empires like the Cholas, the Tughlaqs and Mughals. These all occupied diverse region under their empire and made it more bigger. Larger kingdoms conquered regional states often to expand their empire. When Mughal emperor declined in 18th century, it led to re-emergence of regional status and big empires. Across the subcontinent, regions were left with the legacies of big and small states that ruled over them. Legacies means the rulers left their prints in the form of palaces, wealth, tradition. Example, Ghungat in Hindu way of life is influence of Mughal rule in India, because sub Hindu kingdom were also ruled by Mughal empire. So they followed their own tradition as well as they had to follow traditions of Mughals. Another example is, we use many Urdu words in our language or daily communication. That is also an influence of Mughal rule. Now, let us learn the topic language and region. We will learn which different language was spoken in which different region. In 1318, the great poet Amir Khusro noted that there were different languages in every region of India, like Sindhi in Sindh, which is located in current Pakistan, Lahori in Lahore, Kashmiri in Kashmir, Dwar Samudri in South Karnataka, Telangani in Telangana Andhra Pradesh, Gujarati in Gujarat, Gauri in Bengal, Avadhi in Eastern UP and Hindvi in Delhi. Sanskrit had no boundaries as it did not belong to any region. It was an old language and common people did not know it. Only Brahmins knew this language. Now we will learn old and new religions. In this way, we will learn in those 1000 years what were the changes in old religions, which new religions came up and what changed they had in later part. Hinduism was the religion in India, subcontinent. There were many changes in Hinduism in the course of time, like worshipping of new deities. Deities means gods or goddesses. Caste system became rigid in India in those 1000 years. Like earlier, the caste depended on the occupation. Like for example, a Brahmin is a person who has knowledge, but his son is not good in studies, but he is good in war tactics. So the son of a Brahmin can join army and then his caste will be Kshatriya. So the caste depended on the work one did. Later in those 1000 years, the caste depended on birth. In this way, a child born in Vaishya family had to be Vaishya lifelong. His work did not affect his caste. With this system in existence, it affected more badly to the lower caste, and the upper caste benefited because children or upper caste would enjoy all the benefits even though if he is not fit for, and the people in the lower caste never had much opportunities to come up, and now they would not have either. In those 1000 years, kings constructed many temples and importance of Brahmins was growing. They became dominating group in society. The reason was they knew Sanskrit, which common people did not know or understand. So due to Sanskrit, they earned lot of respect and also were considered knowledgeable people. A part of this, their dominant position was consolidated by support of their patrons, that is new rulers, who wanted to expand their empire or kingdom with the help of their knowledge. One more major development that happened during this period was Bhakti movement. This movement that to reach God, one does not have to go to priests to do rituals. In those 1000 years, when Brahmins started dominating and the lower caste were even, Brahmins did not visit their houses. So how would they reach God? Through this Bhakti movement, people started serving and loving God, the universal consciousness, by themselves. This was about the old religion, Hinduism. Now, those 1000 years, a new religion emerged, that was Islam. This religion came to India through merchants and migrants who started preaching the teachings of Holy Quran. Many rulers were patrons of Islam and the ulama, like big gurus in Hindus, also were taken and patrons of the rulers. The way Hinduism was interpreted in many ways, Islam too was interpreted, means explained in various ways, due to which things changed in course of time. Islam was timely changed, like people were expected. Son-in-law of Prophet Muhammad as their next head after Prophet Muhammad was called Shia Muslim. On the other hand, some people believed Khalifa, their earlier leader of the community, and the next succeeding Khalifa were the authority head. Also, the school of law in Islam, Hanafi and Shafi, mainly in India, keep different thinking, which way Islam also was interpreted in different ways. Now, the next topic is thinking about time and historical periods. We will learn now and how can we divide time into historical periods. Why would we divide time into historical period? Because when we are learning about our over a long period of time, it can have many changes in social, political and economical order. So to study that long time, easily we have to divide the time into periods. Periods with some characteristics which will make us easy to understand that time of period. British historians divided Indian history into three parts: Hindu, Muslim and British. This division basically alone on the basis of the religion of the rulers. Like, if there were Hindu kings, so it was Hindu period. If Muslim kings, then Muslim period. And the Britishers were there, so British period. The history that we learn in class 7th is termed as medieval period. Medieval means middle. Period like first came ancient period that were learned in class 6th from earliest man to 700 AD. Then it was medieval period from 700 AD to 1700 AD. Then after modern period, in this period lot of scientific and technology was advanced, and along with it intellectual advances also happened. In those 1000 years, the societies of the subcontinent reached a level of prosperity that attracted Europeans. Like Europeans, trading companies came to India and defeated the king and started taking away all the wealth. The prosperity started attracting the outsider to come to India. This is where we end with the first chapter of history. I hope you all have understood it well. We will send you next session with question and answer, which you have to write in your history notebooks. Thank you.